This year, Aubuchon Hardware proudly celebrates its 100th birthday. But our story didn't begin a century ago. It began more than a decade before that, as if torn from the pages of a Horatio Alger novel. Georgiana Aubuchon, widowed at just 26, with precious little money, saw no future for her family in Canada, where her children could only work as farmers' helpers or common laborers for next to nothing wages. She made up her mind to leave, setting her sights on a better life in America. In a 1943 letter to his son Billy, who was then a corporal in the Army, William Sr. recalled his life before the Canadian exodus. "I can remember a farmer coming to our house one morning to ask Mother if I could help him for the day. She consented because we needed the money. At day's end, the farmer paid me a full day's wage, 15 cents. It was easy to see that Mother's decision to leave Canada was the right one." Georgiana Aubuchon held a public auction to sell what little furniture she had to finance a new life in America. Armed with the proceeds, she and her four young children yanked up their roots and transplanted them in Fitchburg, Massachusetts. They couldn't have found more fertile soil. William Sr. was just 15 when the family came to America in 1900, but he soon found work in a cotton mill for $3.25 per week. Compared to his previous employment at 15 cents per day, he almost felt rich. The family took in two boarders. Georgiana, in addition to being both mother and father to four young children, worked as a dressmaker 2 days a week. There was reason for optimism. Shortly after Georgiana brought her family to America, the family farm was sold for $2,000. Georgiana, having known adversity, vowed to live off the interest. She did. She would later divide the money between her four children as they came of age. William received his share first. This became the initial investment of Aubuchon Hardware. The year was 1908, a year of inventions and breakthroughs that launched America into the modern age. For the first time, a 700-pound electric ball dropped from a flagpole at Times Square, ushering in the new year. Wilbur Wright flew for nearly 2.5 hours, the world's longest airplane flight. Henry Ford put America on wheels, creating the first production line Model T. Declared Thomas Edison, "Anything, everything is possible." 1908 proved to be a giant leap forward for the Aubuchon family, too. Along with Emile Dion, William purchased a hardware and paint store at 171 Fairmont Street in Fitchburg. The price? $2,800. William paid his half with the $500 he got from his father's estate, plus a $900 loan. A year later, he bought out Dion. For his first 2 years in business, while he paid off his loans, his mother refused to take any money from him. That financial reprieve enabled William's fledgling business to take root and turn a profit. When he finally did have the money to pay his mother back, he realized he owed her a debt that he could never fully repay. He would never stop talking about it. The years that followed, as luck and hard work would have it, were filled with more ups than downs. In 1913, William's youngest brother, John, joined the business as a partner. The business was growing. The company bought its first truck, a brand new 1913 Ford Model T pickup, for $440. Suddenly, William was in the driver's seat of a company that was in the right place at the right time. America was bursting at the seams and needed high-quality hardware products to fuel its growth. In 1917, William and John opened their second store at 621 Main Street. The location was perfect, but the price was daunting, $93,000, an exorbitant sum for the time, more than $1.5 million by today's measure. William, certain the rewards would outweigh the risks, convinced Safety Fund Bank to give him a loan. Aubuchon Hardware was officially a chain. And yet, even as it continued its dramatic growth throughout the 1920s, adding 6 more stores in central Massachusetts by the end of the decade, Aubuchon retained the same values and same character it had as a single store. Henry Ford once said, "A business that makes nothing but money is a poor business." You didn't have to tell William Aubuchon that. A dyed-in-the-wool family man, William transplanted his family values into his business enterprise, and he would stick by those values, come hell or high water. The October 1929 stock market crash ushered in a new era of survival of the fittest in America. But at a time when banks and businesses were failing left and right, Aubuchon Hardware flourished. Tough times meant caution and strict new policies, to be sure, but it didn't mean slowing down. From 1930 to 1939, Aubuchon added 22 new stores. New jobs, new hopes, new horizons. President Franklin D. Roosevelt created his New Deal. Entrepreneur William E. Aubuchon, the former boy who once earned just 15 cents for a day's hard labor, created better deals, providing fair wages to those who wanted work and fair prices for those who needed to buy. It was a formula for success on a level that even he could not have imagined back in 1908. Surviving the Great Depression, the company was soon tested again. December 7, 1941, the Japanese attack on Pearl Harbor launched America headlong into World War II. With Bill Jr., his brothers Maurice and Peter, brother-in-law Marcus Moran, and other young men from the company in uniform, the war years were an especially trying time for Aubuchon Hardware. But William Sr., ever the family man, was determined to minimize the war's financial impact on his family. He made a promise that all Aubuchon executives would get their paychecks over the course of their military service. He was true to his word. With the war years behind them and churning with a new wave of unbridled optimism, Aubuchon Hardware gathered nearly its entire workforce together for a group photo outside its original headquarters at 28 Rollstone Street in Fitchburg. For many in America during the Great Depression, the sky had fallen. But for Aubuchon in post-war America, the sky was the limit. By 1948, at the outset of the baby boom, Aubuchon Hardware boomed too. 32 stores now populated New England. By 1957, a dozen more were added, including many new locations in Vermont. Meanwhile, a second generation was now weaving its way in the Aubuchon family business tapestry, and with them came new merchandising and marketing ideas that enabled Aubuchon to truly become the big one in hardware. Each succeeding decade has brought many changes and dramatic growth for Aubuchon Hardware. Today, Aubuchon's 130 stores in Massachusetts, Vermont, New Hampshire, Maine, Connecticut, and New York feature state-of-the-art point-of-sale computer and telephone systems, all of it aimed to make each customer's experience something truly special. Behind the counters, in the aisles, at the checkouts, are people who know and love the hardware business. And behind those on the front lines is a third and fourth generation management team with both eyes on the road ahead, but with more than an occasional glance in the rearview mirror. Aubuchon Hardware's history is a rich one. It began with a 23-year-old man who once worked as a farmer's helper for just 15 cents a day. A man who saw America as a whole that was, and could remain, greater than the sum of its parts. But only if those parts, and the people behind them, were something very special. His vision continues today.